Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you after your vacation. I always believe that great holidays always increases your productivity. I'm sure you all have come back after these holidays with a better outlook, with an urge to work harder and definitely more potential. So today we are going to start a very important chapter of business studies of class 12th, which is marketing management. So this chapter is important because it includes a lot of interesting facts which you are going to remember all your life, I believe, and also because you will be given an option to create, to have your project work as per this chapter. So I would like to request you all to try to understand this chapter very well. If you have any doubts, any questions regarding any part of the video, you can always write it in the comment box. Before I go forward, I would like you all to like this video and subscribe to my channel. So moving forward with the content of this video. So let's see what are the learning objectives under this chapter. We will be understanding the meaning of marketing. We will be understanding the difference between terms marketing and selling. What are the functions of marketing? Role of marketing in the development of an economy, in a firm, to a society, and of course to the consumers. What are the elements of marketing mix? Classifying the products into different types of different categories, analyzing the factors which affects the price of a product. We will also understand the different channels for distribution of the products, and also we will understand about the main tools of promotion, that is advertising, personal selling, sales promotion and publicity. So let us start this chapter. So the word market, it is such a usual word and we have listened to this word like many times we have heard about this word. So as per a general meaning, what is market? The term market is used for a place where buyers and sellers meet and conduct buying and selling activities. So basically any market in your neighborhood will be a market for you. Right? So this is the general term how we use word market. But yes, it has a big sense as well. In traditional sense, the market means the place where buyers and sellers gather to enter into a transaction involving the exchange of goods and services. But today, business can be conducted on telephone, through mail, internet, etc. So this is a general sense where buyers and sellers meet. What do they meet for? They meet to enter into a transaction. That means one needs something and other is selling something. So this is called a transaction, where the exchange of goods and services takes place. Exchange of goods and services means we go and buy certain goods from the market. Goods can be the things we use on daily basis, or the things we buy really casually, and the things we even don't buy, maybe the industrial goods. So the goods which we can buy on regular basis can be the bread, eggs, milk, etc. The goods we casually buy, that means maybe the vehicles, maybe the furniture of the house, etc. And the things we usually don't buy, but yes, the business exists in those goods also, like industrial goods. Like to create these tables which we are sitting across, so that are created using wood. So we never go into the market and buy wood, but yes, the people who are dealing in furniture business, they go and they buy wood. And they create the finished goods using those materials, and then they sell it to the consumers. So the goods also include consumer goods and industrial goods. So business can be conducted on telephone, through mail, internet. We go to the market and we buy something. This is the very usual form of market. We order a pizza over a phone. So this is a market over phone. Right? We can also order things through mail or through internet. Like in today's time, we are more prone to, you know, keeping ourselves at home, and we are using the internet market. You know, we are using different marketplaces over internet, like we are using Amazon marketplace or Flipkart marketplace. So this is market over internet. So in modern sense, the term market has a really broad meaning. It refers to the set of actual and potential buyers of the product or service which are spread across the globe. All right, so this is what a market is, where you can see people buying things and the things are displayed and people are choosing what they are willing to buy. Next comes the meaning of consumer. So consumer is a very important element of any market. If consumer doesn't exist, there cannot be a market. So we can definitely say that consumer is the kingpin of the market. All right. So thus marketing is not possible without consumers or buyers or customers. So consumers are those people for whom these market offerings are available. These are the people whose demand are met through the markets, through the products, through all the efforts by marketers. So without these consumers, no market can exist. So let's see what is the literal meaning of word consumers. Consumers refers to the people or organization that seeks satisfaction of their needs and wants. So consumers are the people who actually go out, they are offered certain goods, certain services through which they seek satisfaction. They seek satisfaction of their needs and wants. So there is a difference between these words, needs and wants. Let me just discuss it briefly. Like food. Food is a need for us. Food is a need for us. Let's say food. So food is a need for us, and it is definitely a very basic need for us. So when there is a general requirement of certain things, it is a need. But when we go and ask for a particular thing, it becomes specific, it becomes want. When I say I need food, it is a need. But when I say I need pizza in dinner, so it becomes a want. But needs and wants are only useful for a marketer when these are converted into demands. So how need and wants become demand? I need Mercedes. I need a Mercedes, but I don't have money in my pocket to go and buy Mercedes. So it will never be my demand. I will only demand those things which I can go out and buy. I can only demand pizza when I will have rupees 200 in my pocket. So wants becomes demand when people have purchasing power or money to convert them into real objects. All right. So there is this difference between needs, wants, and demand. So for these marketers, demand is very important. If there will be no demand of the product, the manufacturer or the marketer will not create that product. All right. So let us understand the next point. It is for the satisfaction of needs and wants that they move to market to buy the products and service. This is what I was saying. When people have capacity to buy things, then only they will go to the market, they will ask for those things, they will buy those things, and they will satisfy their needs and wants. So this is what we were talking about. This was the meaning of term consumer or customer. After understanding what is consumer or customer, we have to understand who is a marketer or a seller. Let us read this. Marketer can be a person or an organization who makes available the products or services and offers them to the consumers or customers with an intention of satisfying the wants the customer needs and wants. So marketer can be a person, or it can be a group of person, or an organization, or a company. What they do is they make available the products or services. So what do? They make the products or the services available which people needs, which people demands, and offers them to the consumers. Offer means that there should be an exchange mechanism. Exchange mechanism that they offer a product and in return they take something. So definitely the companies, the organization, they offer products for monetary benefits. All right. So the individuals or the organizations makes available the products or services and offers them to the customers with an intention of satisfying their needs. So they have this intention that these goods, these services will be bought by these people because they are willing to satisfy certain needs of them using these products. So this is the whole essence of this marketing thing. People need something and they are offered those things by the marketer. So in brief, we can say if the customer is the seeker of the satisfaction, the marketer is the provider of that satisfaction. So this is definitely an exchange mechanism which works. All right. Moving ahead, we will understand now what is marketing. So marketing is a very broad term which cannot be understood only seeing this page. So you are going to understand marketing in much detail in the next part of this chapter. So just to give you a glimpse of its meaning, let us read this page. Marketing is a social process whereby people exchange goods and services for money or for something of value to them. This is what we have already read previously also. Marketing is a social process. It's a process where different types of members of the society are involved. Why I'm saying that members of society? Because the person who is selling the goods and the people who are buying the goods, they are all a part of this society. So definitely it's a social process where people exchange goods and services. People, what are people doing? They are exchanging goods and services, and what they are doing it for? They are doing it for money. All right, or for something which is of certain value to them. Okay, so let's see what it is written. It is a process by which individuals and groups obtain what they need and want. So whatever I have underlined here are the features of marketing which we are going to study in later part of this chapter. So what they need and want through a market offering and freely exchanging products and services of certain value for them. So marketing is a process where there is one, a need and want; two, there is a market offering; three, there should be free exchanging of goods and services; and four, it should be of certain value for both the people, buyer and seller. So this is what marketing is. Now we will understand these features in detail. What are important features of marketing? As I just mentioned, the first feature is need and want. I have already explained in detail what is meant by need, what is meant by want. So the focus of marketing is always on identifying and satisfying the needs and wants of different people across the society. So needs are very basic to human beings, while wants are the specific things which people need. For example, the need for food may create a want for chapati, rice, pizza, dosa, depending upon the culture of the person. The job of this marketer is to identify the need of the target consumers, maybe a person who is working in the southern part of our country will offer dosas more than chapatis. But if there is a person who is willing to start a hotel business in North India, maybe in New Delhi, so he will definitely go for North Indian food than preferring South Indian food. So it depends upon the target customers. The target customer means the people who are going to be the potential buyers of the product, and offer the products and services so that their needs can be satisfied. So this is all about need and wants. Another thing here to understand is creating a market offering. So market offering means to provide an offer to the public stating the features of the product, maybe the size of the product, quality of the product, taste of the product, and of course the price, and how will that product be available to people. So this is a kind of offering which is open to all, and no marketer can deny this information to the consumers. Consumer has a right to know about the product, then his decision is always on him. Even after knowing about the product, it's his decision whether he's willing to buy that product or not. All right. So I'll give you one more example. A company which is offering like 15 varieties of a cell phone between the price 6,000 to 50,000 has stores across the country. So this is a market offering in which a company is targeting different kinds of buyers, which is ranging from rupees 6,000 to 50,000. So this is a good market offering, I must say. Next comes customer value. So while purchasing a product, consumer always analyzes cost and the satisfaction derived from it. So this is very important. Like if you go out and buy a register, it should cost around 50 to 70 rupees in a particular size. If that register will be given to you in rupees 250, so you will definitely analyze its value, that whatever price I'm paying for this product, is it really worth it? So it should always bring value to the person who is paying the price for it. So customer in this case only buys a product when he believes that the quality or the quantity he is getting definitely matches with the value he is paying. So the job of marketer here is to add value to the product or service to the product so that people can always come ahead and buy his product and not the competitor's product. So this is all about creating customer value. Like we go out and we always buy certain products. We are ready to pay rupees 70 for a Dairy Milk Silk, but we are not ready to pay rupees 60 for some other company. So why we are ready to pay this amount? Because we believe that whatever we are paying for this object brings some value, brings some utility to us. So this is about customer value. Now, what is exchange mechanism? The fourth point, the fourth feature of marketing. So marketing involves exchange of goods and services for money. We have already studied this. So exchange, what is exchange? Exchange refers to a process through which two or more parties come together to obtain a desired product or service from someone, offering the same by giving something in return. For example, if a person is hungry, if a first person is feeling hungry, maybe he may get food by offering to give money or some other products or service in return to someone who is willing to accept the same for food. So this can work for him. So exchange is referred to as essence of marketing. If there is no need of exchange, there will be no need of marketing. There will be no such system where people will be going ahead creating products for someone else and getting something in return. So the whole marketing depends upon exchange. The essence is definitely an exchange of marketing. I'm sure you have understood all the content which I tried to explain in this session. If you have any queries, doubts, or your questions, you can always write it in the comment box. You can also mail me your queries over this email on your screen. I would love to answer them. You can subscribe to my channel to get the notification for my further videos. Please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hope to see you soon. Thank you very much.